Good morning and welcome to IIJ's virtual second edition powered by GIA. We have with us today Mr. KP Abdul Salam, Group Executive Director of Malabar Group. He is joining us from Dubai. Thank you, Salam Bhai. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to see you in this Christmas New Year week and we welcome you here. So, Salam Bhai, how has been the season now in Middle East?
Last quarter, 2020. Started with a very good, very positive sign. We had a very good Diwali Tandara sales here in this season. Of course, you know, we had a very bad second quarter, and third quarter was just, opening up the markets and all those things. The fourth quarter, we came out with very well. And October, November also did very well. November was one of the best months for the last 2 years, because there are a lot of deferred purchases were happening in this season also, because people were out of market for quite a good time. They all came back and they were buying the products, and we had a very positive sign. December also, we had a very good hop and it was started very well. And in between, the message came of the second wave of the disease and the new version of Corona in UK and all. It got disrupted a little bit of the consumer sentiments. But I hope that slowly it will wait, and we are hoping for a good closing for this December. Overall, the season is doing
great to hear that. Salam Bhai, and also we are seeing a lot of tourists and tourism started back in Middle East. So, in the last edition, Salam Bhai, in the last edition of IIJS Virtual in October, your group from India and Middle East really participated in large numbers, you know, your showroom managers, merchandisers, and engaged with our manufacturers. So what is your experience been, you know, what is your group's experience been with the IIJS Virtual platform?
I should congratulate the DJPC for this opportunity which we have given in this bad time, because everybody were on a crossroads and what to do and how to do the business and all those things. DJPC came out with this IIJS Virtual, and it was a very good opportunity to, in the bad time, to see the products. Of course, I must say that it will not replace the physical, physically present there and going through the IIJS. It is a, normally IIJS is not only a trade fair. It is a, I always say that it is a kind of pilgrimage for our jewelers. Okay, once or twice in a year, go to Mumbai and meet everybody and go through that experience and get that positive vibe among you and all. That all we are missing in this year, because of course nobody can help it, because that was the situation that time. But the virtual thing, to a certain extent, that has helped us to get connected with the vendors and see the products and to place the orders for the future, for the Diwali presentation, Diwali preparation, it helped us to get connected with many of our vendors. Even though the platform was ready and it worked to a certain extent, but what I felt is that many of the vendors were not ready with their products, still on closed condition, and people were not expecting what kind of reaction will come from the market and all those things. But having said that, whoever have products and who have shown it well, and we could place orders with them, and we could communicate with them very well, and we had a good selection of products during that time.
Thank you very much. You know, this was one of the things which people were apprehensive in the first edition. You know, a lot of, you're right, a lot of factories are working at 50 or maybe even 40% levels.
Yes.
And they were trying to see how to gauge the entire IIJS virtual experience. But this time around, you know, all those things have been taken care of, you know, and people are really, people have really worked hard. You know, all the 500 participants or the manufacturers have worked really hard from across Mumbai, Jaipur, Coimbatore, Hyderabad, Rajkot, you know, Ahmedabad. So, what is the product, you know, trend or a consumer trend, Salam Bhai, which you have been seeing in the last quarter, like in the last 3 months in Dubai or entire Middle East, like in Saudi Arabia or in Kuwait or Qatar or Bahrain? And what will you advise our manufacturers on what to offer, you know, in both in terms of product as well as services?
Changes in the market after the COVID lockdown situation, and although there is a very big change happened in this market. Whatever we are seeing for the last 3 or 4 months of the customer buying is that they are buying the designs. Mostly it was, especially in the gold and all, we were seeing that, earlier, you know, that gold jewelry is more of a combination of an investment buying and design buying. So people are buying gold or buying designs. This was the situation. I think most of the customers, they are looking for designs. They are ready to spend on designs and all those things. So there should be we are expecting a lot of innovations from the design part from the manufacturers. There is a good affluent customers coming into the market who can afford, because the disposable income of those kind of customers are good now, because they were spending this money in many other markets, like traveling, holidaying, or spending on other things and all those things, this which is not happening now, because people are not traveling, people are not taking holidays and all. So they are ready to spend on personal accessories, and especially the gifting has come out very well, because family bonding has become strong because of this COVID situation and all those things. So gifting is a major thing, and people started gifting each other. Self-gifting is also happening. So a lot of design innovation is required in this the jewelry, especially the lifestyle jewelry products, which we wear. One is that occasional buying, and one is that lifestyle buying, everyday wearing and all those things, because occasions are coming down. There's no big parties are happening, weddings are not happening as before. So people want to buy for their daily wear kind of designs and products. So low weight, good design products are more in demand.
Salam bhai, now Dubai Shopping Festival is going on. You are on the board of directors for Dubai Golden Jewelry Group. Do you feel there is a change category-wise, before it used to be majorly gold, like you said, it was either buying for investment or for design. But do you see now, studded jewelry also doing well, like diamond jewelry, color gemstone, like rubies, emeralds, jadao, kundan? Can you just give us an idea of what's happening in Dubai and Middle East to all our viewers, because everybody will be listening to you, on this telecast. So what do you see has changed in the last 3 months?
There is a very big shift towards the studded jewelry. That is what I have observed now, because even our own share in studded jewelry has increased compared to the gold jewelry during this time, because that is the that's a trend toward across. I think in India also that is the trend now. It's going for diamonds in a major thing. Polished diamond is doing very well. Even in uncut diamond jewelry is doing well. And gemstones jewelry is also doing. Color stones and especially the ruby, emerald and all are very much in demand. Not only Indians. Earlier it was a product which bought by Indians only. Mainly Indians. So now even Arab customers, they are buying, they are appreciating this product. They are buying this product. Even if the shopping malls and all, you can sell this product to Arabs and even Western expatriates, even Chinese are buying these kind of products. So there is a very good opportunity to develop in this area. I will say that we have to come out with a lot of designs to appeal to other ethnicities in these products. We should not concentrate only on the traditional Indian customers who are buying this, maybe a South Indian or especially the Andhra and Telangana people. They were the buyers mainly for these colored stone products. But now it is happening that it is appealing to everyone. And we should come out with the designs which appeal to other ethnicities also in these designs. Regarding this shopping festival, it started a little earlier. It was started in 17th of December itself. Even though this is the time, I mean, after Christmas, it will pick up because people start traveling to Dubai immediately after the Christmas. And the New Year is a very big thing here in Dubai. A lot of people are coming here. A lot of tourists are coming there because Dubai is the only tourist destination which is open after, I think, Maldives. Maldives is also his one destination. Dubai is one of the hot destination for tourists. A lot of Indian tourists are coming here, and Dubai is safe also. In that way, they take care of all the healthcare.
Actually, Dubai is very safe, you know, and people are really finding it easy to travel to Dubai, and that's why you see so much of Indian tourism. One more question of which our viewers would like to know, Salam Bhai, is that, are you seeing a lot of youngsters, you know, in Middle East, you know, moving towards jewelry from other categories, especially, you know, because what we have seen in India is because of during the pandemic, with the increase in price of gold, you know, and the trust in gold increased dramatically for the category of, you know, between 25 years of age and maybe 40 years of age, which was not there before. You know, they were actually going away from the category, and they were doing a lot of other things like mobile phones and expensive holidays, you know, and a lot of other gadgets and all. But they realized in the pandemic, you know, in a lot of ways that gold is the place to go. You know, jewelry is the thing to go. Do you see this happening in Middle East as well? And is there to this audience, because do you think because of this audience, this entire studded jewelry fashion, you know, stylish jewelry is moving more?
This is one development we have seen for the last year. I mean, we were also getting prepared for this kind of change. I would thank many of these jewelry brands which has taken interest to develop the product for the youngsters, for the millennials and the younger generation, and market those product. I mean, one best example is Tanishq has come out with Mia concept, and they were marketing it very well. We also, from Malabar also, we have introduced a kind of sub brand called Zol, and we were marketing it very well, like among the target market, which give us a very good result for these things. And we have seen a very good acceptance from the youngsters towards jewelry. Because again, I will say that their spending were into different other things. Of course, other gadgets, electronic. But again, the spending is coming to jewelry. The other major change is that the target group in that, now they are becoming more and more independent. They are earners now. They are getting good salary. I mean, the new system and new market condition gives them good salaries and good livelihood and all. They are taking their own decisions. I mean, it's not that earlier things, okay, what the parents buy for them and what the parents, you know, they are earning and they are spending. So that kind of shift has taken place in the started their own spending. So it's an opportunity for the jewelry is to target into this new class of customers.
Finally, one last question on some numbers, Salam Bhai. When do you see we will come back to 100% level of business? You know, we were discussing with Tohid Bhai in the month of September and October, first week, that, you know, Dubai was at around 40% level at that point of time. Where do you see Dubai now, and what percentage, say, compared to last year? And when do you see this entire business cycle coming to 100% levels compared to before pandemic?
We are in a good hope. I mean, the 2021 will come back definitely. I mean, especially in the Middle East, and Dubai will come back very strongly. Even the government, Dubai has announced a very huge budget yesterday. And they are going to spend a lot of money, and a lot of programs are there. Likewise, any other Middle Eastern country, Saudi Arabia is also spending a lot of money in the market. Kuwait is coming out with a lot of projects and all those things. So there will be a lot of coming back happening in the market. Now the vaccination is there on the mass. Everybody is starting, all the GCC countries started vaccinating the people. And hopefully within next 2-3 months, I mean, 50-60% of the, at least 40-50% of the people get vaccinated. And this fear of COVID will slowly get away from the atmosphere. We were expecting that first quarter 2021 will be a good month, which will not be as good as the previous condition. I mean, now we are running almost around 20% less than the normal conditions it could have been. But I think by second quarter 2021, the market will reach the situation where we were. Hopefully by that time, I mean, the COVID things also will be under control, and we all hope for a good year to come.
Thank you very much, Salam Bhai, for your time. It's brilliant talking to you. Your insights are really, really valuable for our industry, and everybody who will be listening to this telecast will really gain a lot of knowledge, you know, on how it will go. And I think May 14th or May 15th is the first Eid this year, you know. Ramadan is April 14th, it starts. Yes, so yes, I think by that time is when you are looking at, you know, things normalizing, and things will be very, very good.
Thank you. Thank you, Sameer.
Thank you very much, sir. Thanks a lot.